Now let's look at atrioventricular blocks. The first one is called first degree. An atrioventricular or AV heart block, usually caused by a delay, sometimes absent an inconsistent electrical conduction pathway traveling through the AV node. These AV blocks are described as a first degree, which has a prolonged P to R interval beyond 0.20 seconds. The rhythm is regular with a normal or slow rate. P waves are present and upright with a P to R interval greater than 0.20 seconds. The QRS complex is between 0.06 and 0.11 seconds, and the P wave to QRS ratio is 1:1. There is usually a minimal clinical significance with this form of heart block. A second degree, otherwise called Mobitz type 1 block, which is characteristic of having a progressively widening P to R interval, which is then followed by a QRS complex that is progressively delayed at the AV node until it completely is absent altogether, which then only shows a P wave, but no QRS following it. So, in interpreting this ECG, we see that the rhythm with this type of second degree block is regularly irregular. The rate is normal or slow, and P waves are present and upright. The P to R interval is progressively lengthening until a QRS complex is dropped altogether. The QRS complex is between 0.06 and 0.11 seconds, and the P wave to QRS ratio is 1:1 until a P wave is blocked. It is commonly caused by heart disease affecting the AV node, vagal stimulation, oftentimes associated with a difficult bowel movement, or coughing fits, or in certain cases, medications. Now the third type is called second degree Mobitz type 2, and usually occurs when the heart block is below the AV node. Characteristically, the ECG appears to have intermittent blocks where some P waves do not have QRS complexes following. There's no elongation of the P to R interval. In this case of the type 2 heart block, the rhythm is variable depending on the P to QRS ratio. The rate is variable but will usually be slow. While P waves are present and upright, the P to R interval will be between 0.12 and 0.20 seconds of the normally conducted complexes. QRS complex is 0.06 to 0.11 seconds, while the P wave to QRS is variable as well and can be seen as 2:1, 3:1, or even as much as 4:1 and beyond. This type 2 heart block is usually from a more advanced and severe heart disease process, and it can originate from damage that is below the bundle of His. Because of this, Mobitz type 2 can deteriorate more quickly into a symptomatic dysrhythmia and even become a third degree heart block. And now lastly, the granddaddy of all AV blocks, the third degree complete AV heart block. This happens when electrical conduction is completely blocked between the atria and the ventricles. The exact location of the block can vary, but it's usually somewhere around the AV node or lower, but will disassociate the SA pacemaker from the AV or bundle of His pacemakers, thereby creating an ECG that has a regular P wave, regular QRS waves, but they will be at different rates, completely disassociated altogether. In this case, the ECG is as follows. The rhythm is regular, but the rate is bradycardic, between 20 to 40 beats per minute. P waves are present and upright, while the P to R interval is variable with no real pattern. QRS complex is greater than 0.11 seconds, and the P wave to QRS ratio is variable. Now, the clinical significance of this dysrhythmia is serious. The patient will be usually symptomatic and unstable due to the very slow bradycardic rhythm. Remember, the block is stopping any pace that would be originated from the SA node. Therefore, the ventricular pacemaker will stimulate a pulse rate closer to 20 to 40 beats per minute, which is usually not enough to keep a stable blood pressure. This is why the ECG will usually have wide QRS complexes. Studies have shown that third-degree heart blocks may be transient or permanent, depending on the underlying cause.